Hello friends, welcome back to another episode by Engineering Today, and hope you're all having a great time. Recently, there have been several notable developments at the SpaceX launch facility. First and foremost, Starship 25 has been de-stacked from the SuperHeavy Booster B9. The fully prepared ship and booster combination has been deliberately separated. With no plans for flight termination system installation due to the absence of FAA launch approval, it's unclear why they've done that. Last night, the ship transport stand was relocated to the OLM de-stack area. Overnight, a ship transport stand was moved to the orbital launch mount area in anticipation of an upcoming disassembly. Currently, Ship 25 remains firmly in place by the tower as there are no transport-ready SPMTs available at the pad. Meanwhile, Kathy Luders from SpaceX has indicated that Starship's second launch could occur in approximately 2 to 3 weeks, stating, "Hoping we get this done in the next 2 to 3 weeks." The exact reason for the recent disassembly remains unclear, with some speculating that it may be in preparation for a static fire test of Ship 26. We should soon learn more about the purpose behind this decision. On the other hand, the Federal Aviation Administration's acting head, Polly Trottenberg, revealed on Wednesday that the agency is considering granting a launch license to SpaceX's Starship rocket as early as next month, October. This implies that there's no reason to expect the launch in September. Trottenberg expressed optimism about the ongoing collaboration between the FAA and SpaceX, emphasizing that their teams are working closely together. She said, "We're working well with them and have been in good discussions. Teams are working together, and I think we're optimistic sometime next month." However, before SpaceX can proceed with the launch, they still need to secure environmental approval from the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Services, though Trottenberg did not provide an estimate for how long this process might take. In the aftermath of the April test launch, the FAA conducted a thorough technical investigation. The results of this investigation prompted the agency to require SpaceX to implement numerous corrective measures. The April 20th launch saw the rocket successfully lift off from its Texas launch pad, but ultimately explode about 4 minutes into the flight. This test was a critical step in demonstrating the rocket's ability to reach space for the first time. The FAA's investigation identified multiple root causes for the Starship's failure and outlined 63 specific corrective actions that SpaceX must undertake before they can launch the rocket again. These actions include hardware modifications to prevent leaks and fires, as well as strengthening the rocket's launch pad to protect against debris and sand being kicked up during launch. In a detailed post published on its website last Friday, SpaceX provided a comprehensive account of the issues that plagued its recent mission. The difficulties began to manifest themselves during the initial ascent phase of the flight. It was at this critical juncture that the spacecraft encountered a series of challenges, the most significant being fires resulting from propellant leaks in the aft end of the Super Heavy booster. This unnerving development, which occurred in the early stages of the mission, marked the start of a cascade of problems that ultimately led to a catastrophic outcome. The SpaceX update stated, "During ascent, the vehicle sustained fires from leaking propellant in the aft end of the Super Heavy booster, which eventually severed connection with the vehicle's primary flight computer." It's important to note that the closure of the mishap investigation does not automatically mean that Starship launches will resume immediately at SpaceX's Boca Chica launch site in Texas. However, it does bring SpaceX one step closer to achieving its goal of sending Starship into space, a significant milestone required before the company can use the reusable rocket for commercial satellite missions and human landings on the moon in collaboration with NASA. In response to the FAA's announcement about the corrective actions, Elon Musk questioned the specifics of the 63 corrective actions in a post on Friday. As per FAA regulations, SpaceX led the investigation into the Starship incident and compiled the list of corrective actions, which must be approved by the FAA before a new Starship launch license can be granted. This process involves a comprehensive review of the rocket's flight trajectory, safety considerations, and accident probabilities, all of which impact public safety in the vicinity of the launch site. On the other hand, Musk says that SpaceX has successfully overcome the formidable logistical challenges that initially impeded the launch of its second test flight for the Starship. Elon Musk, the billionaire visionary at the helm of SpaceX, acknowledged the completion and documentation of 57 out of the 63 items mandated by the FAA for the second Starship flight. Notably, 6 of the remaining items pertain to subsequent flights, underlining the company's commitment to not only rectify past issues, but also ensure the safety and success of future missions. Musk shared his satisfaction and appreciation on X on Sunday, September 10th, recognizing SpaceX's achievement. Although a specific launch date for Starship Flight 2 has not been officially disclosed by SpaceX, Elon Musk has expressed that the mission can proceed promptly upon the FAA's issuance of a launch license. By the way, on the 13th of September, something truly uplifting happened. The day was filled with excitement as buses loaded with enthusiastic workers pulled up at the LC. The atmosphere was immediately transformed by the sound of cheering and laughter that echoed through the area. It was evident that something special was about to happen. The employees were clearly in high spirits, and their energy was infectious. It was heartwarming to see them celebrating their achievements with such enthusiasm and camaraderie. Later, it was revealed that the entire gathering was for a unique and momentous occasion, capturing a spectacular image in front of the mighty Starship. The sense of unity and purpose among the employees was palpable, and it was clear that they were all working together to achieve something remarkable. We should understand how important it is to celebrate not just the end result, but also the journey and the people who make it possible. Meanwhile, in the Starbase facility, significant developments have been unfolding. One intriguing event took place during this period, a cryogenic proof testing of B-10 at Massey's site. However, it raised some eyebrows as an unusual phenomenon manifested itself. While the CH4 tank exhibited a substantial accumulation of frost, the LOX tank remained mysteriously devoid of any visible frost. On the 12th of September, B-10 made its way out of Mega Bay 1, making room for further activities at Massey's location. Simultaneously, B-11 embarked on a journey of its own, transitioning from the rocket garden to occupy the now vacant space at Mega Bay 1. Meanwhile, another intriguing development was taking shape with B-13 poised to reach new heights. The LOX section of B-13 was seen making its way into Mega Bay 1, suggesting that this particular behemoth was about to grow even taller. As we eagerly anticipate the arrival of October, let us remain optimistic and hold on to the belief that the future holds promising and wonderful possibilities. While we may not know what October will bring, it's essential to approach it with a sense of hope and positivity. After all, each new month brings fresh opportunities, experiences, and moments of joy and growth. And that's all for now. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.